What's up, guys, and welcome back to another episode of Nail That Tone, a series that's all about helping you guys achieve some of the most legendary tones of all time. In this episode, we're talking about the legendary Rust in Peace by Megadeth. Of course, there's so many cool stuff to talk about, so let's get into it. So this week, we're talking Rust in Peace, arguably one, if not the greatest metal record of all time. So as always with the Nail That Tone series, the first thing we're talking about is finger tone. So for this episode, I really wanted to highlight Dave Mustaine's really articulate and really tight rhythm playing. So in the Rust in Peace, especially if we're talking about Holy Wars, I definitely hear a very gritty, but also a very articulate and very staccato sounding rhythm guitar. In order to show you guys kind of some of the characteristics that I'm talking about, I actually recorded a mono track, and here is the isolated guitar track of that, and you'll be able to hear not only that grittiness that I mentioned earlier about this guitar tone, but also the performance of it has to be very staccato and tight. Anyway, guys, let's take a listen to this example. So as you guys heard, it definitely has that grittiness in the guitar tone, which is of course a big part of it, but when it comes to the performance, again, you really want to highlight that staccato-ness and really get that nice articulation. So now we're talking about what was used on the actual record. Now for my research, I pretty much went online and went through all the different rumors. I essentially came to the realization that it is not 100% confirmed exactly what was used, especially if we're talking about the Holy Wars guitar tone. It's safe to assume that there are a few preamps and guitar amps that we can speculate were used on this record. Now for this particular video, I'm gonna make a case that the Bogner Triple Giant was actually the preamp used for this particular record. So the best evidence I was able to find is actual video evidence showing that Megadeth at the time during the Rust in Peace tour actually had the Bogner Triple Giant in their guitar rack. Now the very specific Bogner Triple Giant that I'm referring to is actually a very rare hand-wired version of this particular preamp. Now there is speculation that Megadeth used the Bogner Fish preamp, however there is no video evidence of Megadeth having the Bogner Fish preamp in their rack during this Rust in Peace era. And it wasn't until later that we actually see some photographic evidence of Megadeth using the Bogner Fish. So it's safe to assume that it's not as likely that they used the Bogner Fish, and instead they probably most likely used the earlier and older Bogner Triple Giant. So when it comes to guitars that were used on this record, it's probably safe to assume, since during this early period of Megadeth, Mustaine was definitely a big sponsor and user of Jackson guitars. So it's very likely that Dave Mustaine was using his King V, which had Seymour Duncan pickups. And when it comes to guitar cabinets, it's probably very likely that they used some kind of Marshall cabinet, because Marshall has always been sort of a go-to for Dave Mustaine when it comes to his guitar cabinets. So now we're talking about the gear that I used to get the tone that you guys heard in the beginning of the video. So when it comes to the gear that I use, I actually use a profile pack for the Kemper that I actually got from a fellow YouTuber by the name of Michael Nielsen. So Michael Nielsen is a fellow YouTuber who has a really cool channel that you guys should check out. And he kind of tends to specialize in early and rare preamps from like the 80s and 90s. So he has a lot of cool stuff and a lot of cool information on really rare preamp sets that no one tends to talk about or make content about. So I highly recommend that you check out his channel. I don't know the guy personally, but I know he makes good content and he definitely knows what he's talking about when it comes to these preamps. So when it comes to the cab and guitar that I use, I essentially just use my Majesty guitar. And when it comes to the cab, I just use the built-in IR that came with the profile, so I didn't change much there. So when it comes to other gear that I think would work for this guitar tone, you definitely want an amp that has a kind of a nice characteristic to it that kind of embodies a little bit of that grittiness that we hear on this album. And you don't want a super kind of clean or kind of almost overly distorted amp as well. You want something that has that kind of that British kind of grit that we kind of hear on the album. So that's what I would recommend using. And when it comes to guitar and cabinets, I would say just focus on having a guitar that of course has humbuckers and sounds good to you. And when it comes to cabinets, just playing a guitar cabinet that you likely like and sounds good to you. And that's pretty much it. I think the tone of Rust in Peace can be kind of at least certainly described again as very gritty. It has to have that grit, that mid kind of bite that you don't always hear on every single amp. You know, it's a very kind of unique sound, but if you can get it or have something that kind of embodies that, I think that would get you pretty close. Anyway, guys, that's pretty much it for this video. If you learned something cool about this guitar tone, go ahead and leave a like, comment, and consider subscribing, because we release videos like these on a weekly basis. So hopefully, guys, we will see you in the next video.